Fatima to Zahra complains to her father in her last days regarding the way she was treated after his martyrdom. She says, ماذا على من شم تربة أحمد ألا يشم مدى الزمان غواليا صبت علي مصائب لو أنها صبت على الأيام صرن لياليا. If the problems had fell on me, had fallen on a bright day, then even that day would have turned into the darkest night. But Fatima to Zahra, why do you lament this way? What did they do to the mother of patience for her to complain in this manner? They never let the wound of losing her father to heal. They continue to torment her, reminding her that her father has left the world. Not only did they not let her mourn over her father, they stole the rights from her beloved husband and imam. What Fatima to Zahra went through, only Allah knows. And tonight we shall remember a specific event which led to the martyrdom of not one but two pure, innocent, infallible souls, the Lady of Light and her unborn child. How ironic is it that these same individuals who were the first to congratulate Amir al-Mu'mineen on the day of Ghadir were the same individuals who were the most angered when he did not pay allegiance to them. They stole his rights given to him by Allah, and they expected him to give allegiance to their evil ways. In fact, they were so adamant in doing so that they dispatched an army to his house in order for him to do so. Ajarakum Allah, an army went to the house of Fatima to Zahra, and they began to shout and call out for Ali to come out of that house. When the enemies of Allah approached, Fatima to Zahra told them to leave the vicinity of the house. Then the evil tyrants made a threat which changes the course of history. He said, O Ali, come out of that house or we shall burn it with you inside. Another member of the army said to the evil tyrant, O man, this is the house of Fatima to Zahra. This is the house of Rasulullah, and she is within the house, Fatima. The evil tyrant, the so-called leader of the Muslims, replied, wherein he got told that Fatima to Zahra is within the house, and he replies with, so what? What an arrogant fool. The enemy of Allah then ordered for some firewood to be brought and placed around the house. Ya Allah, this is the house of Fatima. This is the house of Allah's pure chosen ones, the Ahlul Bayt. But they didn't care. They were only chasing after their dunya. They were only chasing this stolen power. Ajarakum Allah. And then they lit the house alight, and the flame set alight. Fatima to Zahra is narrated to have said, when the fire engulfed the door and the black smoke began to enter the house, I began to choke from the intensity of the smoke. In these moments, Fatima to Zahra rushed towards the door. Ya Mu'mineen, in order for her to stop the enemies from entering inside the house. But as Fatima al-Zahra stood behind the door, the enemy of Allah kicked open the door, crushing Fatima between the door and the wall. This is a young, tender woman. This is the ruhs of Rasulullah. But they crushed her between the door and the wall. The enemy of Allah, when he heard the voice of Fatima, he was about to turn away. But then he remembered what Imam Ali did to his forefathers on the battlefield, and his heart filled with anger. He says himself, I kicked the door a second time, further crushing Fatima between the door and the wall. O Mu'mineen, there was a protruding nail coming out from that door, a sharp nail that entered the body of Fatima, a sharp nail that punctured the lung of Fatima. Where al-bab اختفت فاطم ولا ذايت عصرها الما لهم روى ولا ذايت بيا ذنب توسدها المنية يا والله بيا ذنب توسدها يا Fatima al-Zahra disappeared behind the door. She sought protection, yet he squeezed her. The one with no conscience, she sought protection. For what sin was she killed? The enemies of Allah entered the house. Ajarakum Allah, they see Fatima, and he slapped Fatima on her cheeks. This is the rose of Rasulullah. Imam al-Sadiq said that when he slapped Fatima, the earring broke and she fell to the floor. They didn't stop there. When they saw Fatima laying on the floor, he kicked Fatima on her stomach. Wa muhsina, if Muhsin hadn't been killed between the door and the wall, surely the kick to her stomach would have killed him. She calls out, Fidda Sanidini, Fidda, come to my aid. This narration breaks the hearts of the mu'mineen. When Fatima al-Zahra was laying there on the floor, with her face beaten and with a broken rib, acknowledging that Muhsin is now shaheed, and tears coming down from her cheek, she turns across the room, and who does her eyes meet? It meets the eyes of Amir al-Mu'mineen. What horror, what anger, what rage coming from Imam Ali. But what could he do? For this was instructions from Rasulullah to be patient and not to wage war. After some time, Fatima al-Zahra lays there on her deathbed, and Amir al-Mu'mineen began to converse with her. Fatima al-Zahra would say to Imam Ali, this is the last day on earth for me, and I am both happy and sad. Oh Fatima, why happy? For soon my troubles will be over, and I will be meeting Rasulullah. But oh Fatima, why sad? Because I will be departing from you, Ya Ali. Ajarakum Allah. She continued to converse with him, in telling him requests and orders for him to carry out. She told him, oh Ali, keep Fidda in the house. She was more of a servant. She was more like a daughter than a servant to me. Oh Ali, go bury me in the night so the enemies do not attend my janazah. As Amir al-Mu'mineen was was listening to her. He would watch his wife as the soul was leaving her body. Then she continued to say, "Oh Ali, I know how much you love my children, but be careful of Hussein, for he loved me dearly. Be like a mother to him also." She continued and then she stopped and she said, "Farewell Ali, bid me farewell." Amir al-Mu'mineen choked with sorrow and tears coming out from his eyes. Only Allah knows how he had the power to say, "Goodbye Fatima, goodbye Ya Zahra." It is narrated that Amir al-Mu'mineen eulogized after the death of Fatima, "نفسي على زفراتها معبوسة يا ليتها خرجت مع الزفرات لا خير بعدك في الحياة إنما أبكي مخافة أن تطول عمري." So long that I will live I shall moan and sigh. I wish my soul came out with moans and sighs. There is no goodness in life after you. No, I cry because I fear my life will be prolonged after you. Remember the time when the angel of death came to the house of Rasulullah to take his soul. He knocked on the door out of respect to Fatima. And now the angel of death comes to the house, but he finds no door. And he sees Fatima to Zahra in this state. We ask you, O angel of death, did you ask permission for angel Jibra'il and Mika'il to come with you to help you and assist you in removing that nail from her lung? Ajarakum Allah. Later, Amir al-Mu'mineen was washing the body of Fatima to Zahra. This narration truly breaks the hearts of the Mu'mineen because of what's happened to the heart of the lion of Allah, Imam Ali. As he was washing the body, Asma narrates that he suddenly stopped and he began to cry intensely. This warrior on a battlefield starts to cry intensely. "Oh Imam Ali, why do you cry? What happened, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen?" He stopped washing the body when his hand came over the cracked ribs of Fatima. رحم الله من نادى وفاطمة رحم الله من نادى ومحسنا. Oh Ali, they stole your rights from you, Ya Ali. Oh Ali, they broke into your house, Ya Ali. Oh Ali, they slapped your wife on her face, Ya Ali. Oh Ali, they beat her down to the ground, Ya Ali. Oh Ali, they cracked her ribs. How did she breathe during those days, Ya Ali? And Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, they killed your unborn child, Muhsin, Ya Ali. رحم الله من نادى ومحسنا رحم الله من نادى وشهيدا رحم الله من نادى ومظلوما. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلبون. والعاقبة للمتقين.